So welcome to Expert Talks by Kalkine TV. I'm Sage, and today's guest is Jennifer Chow, CEO and Managing Director of Chimeric Therapeutics. And for some background, Chimeric Therapeutics is committed to developing the most innovative and promising cell therapies. And the company has a pipeline of natural killer, or NK, cell-derived therapies and T-cell-derived therapies under different phases of clinical trials. And Jennifer Chow, the CEO and Managing Director of Chimeric Therapeutics, who has 20 years' experience in commercial strategy for cell therapy and oncology and more, will share her insights on the recent developments at this biotech firm. Welcome to the show, Jennifer.
Well, thank you so much for having me, Sage. It's great to see you again.
Yes, so great that we can connect and catch up on the news from Chimeric. I believe it's been an extremely busy year for you.
It has. It has been a very, very busy year, and we're thrilled with the progress we've been making.
That's great. Well, hopefully you're getting through the delays that were caused by the pandemic era. And I guess you're getting through that the bottleneck that might have built up as well.
Yes, absolutely. I think the pandemic years have certainly had an impact on all of us.
Yes. Well, Chimeric is busily developing cancer treatments based on cell therapies. Can you help our viewers understand what cell therapy is briefly?
Absolutely, Sage. And it sounds probably much more complicated than it actually is. Cell therapy, in its sort of simplest idea, is just when you're using the body's cells, live cells, to be able to cure or treat a disease. And probably the most simple way to think about it, or what a cell therapy is, Sage, is actually a blood transfusion. Right? So everybody's familiar with the idea of people that have blood transfusions to save their lives. That's a cell therapy. The cell therapies we're developing just happen to have, you know, a little bit more engineering to them. They have some genetic enhancements, things like that. But essentially, it all starts in the same place where we're using live cells to be able to treat diseases.
That sounds like a very organic process. We'd love to find out more, because I'm not sure if organic is the right word, to be honest, although it sounds like you're working with the body's natural structure of proteins and cells. We'd love to find out more through this interview. So one of your research projects was recently the cover story in the highly prestigious journal Nature Cancer. Congratulations about that.
Thank you so much. Yeah, that was wonderful news for us.
And what does this development actually mean for Chimeric?
Yes, Sage, you know what? It really is quite incredible to have the CAR-T, this is our CDH17 CAR-T, featured on the cover of Nature Cancer. And so that CAR-T cell therapy has been in development at the University of Pennsylvania for over a decade. And they have done an incredible amount of work over that past decade to really optimize the CDH17 CAR-T, making sure that we build it so it is the best for safety and efficacy, testing it to make sure that it is going to be safe when we go to look to put it in humans. And the work that the team at the University of Pennsylvania did to develop and optimize and then test the CDH17 CAR, I believe was just so elegant and truly, you know, field leading, that they found this new target for cancer, the CDH17 antigen target for CAR-Ts, that, you know, it wound up on the cover of Nature Cancer, being obviously recognized as the important work it is for the field today. So for us, it really just means that the work that the team at University of Pennsylvania has done on our CAR-T, the CDH17 CAR-T, is really being recognized for how elegant and impressive it is. And I think it gives us a great foundation as we're getting ready to move that asset into clinic. So it gives us a lot of confidence as we're moving that asset towards clinical trials now.
Exactly, because while you're working with these such high-level experiments at this preclinical stage, it sounds great in theory, but if you're getting the confidence of the fact that it's going to work in practice, the dedication that the team puts into it must really pay off. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Chimeric has received excellent outcomes from phase one study of the core NK platform as well. So where do you see this program progressing in the upcoming months, please?
Yeah, I think, you know what, Sage, you're absolutely right. Our core NK platform, which uses NK cells in an off-the-shelf therapy, has had an incredibly exciting couple of months. There was initial phase one clinical data that was published. And what we saw in that data was incredibly encouraging for us. We saw efficacy, safety, we saw expansion and persistence, which really means the cells are staying alive. So really important markers for us. I think probably what was most notable in that data to us, though, was that in blood cancers, we saw there was three patients treated. It was a very small dose escalation trial. There were three patients that were treated with blood cancers. All three of those patients were able to achieve disease stability. And one of those patients actually had a complete response. So Sage, their cancer was gone. And probably, you know, the most significant thing was not just was it gone, but 16 months later, it's still gone. So really, really promising results with that phase one clinical trial. So in the upcoming months, your question about where do we see it going, we really are looking to build off that trial. Everything we learned in that trial about which patients are really responding well to the NK platform, you know, its safety and how we go forward to really continue to develop it. So we see, you know, starting to build out and design and develop new trials.
That is amazing news to hear that it has actually worked and helped to save somebody's life so far.
Exactly. Yeah. But you know what? That is the most rewarding part of what we do. When you hear a story like that, it was a young girl, Sage, in her mid-30s. And to hear 15, 16 months later, she's still cancer-free is pretty incredible.
Of course. The agreement with the US-based Woozi Advanced Therapies sounds like a strategic move.
Yes.
We would love to know the specific benefits of this partnership and how it will enable further clinical studies.
It's a great question, Sage. So Woozi is a very, very well-known large manufacturer of cell therapies, numbers of other things, but our partner is the Advanced Therapies Group, and they really have expertise and experience in manufacturing cell therapies. And for us, we were looking for a partner that had that expertise and experience that would allow us to continue to grow our clinical programs. So we needed someone that could continue to manufacture to larger numbers and had the capacity to grow with us. And we are so excited to have found a partner in Woozi. There, we're going to be manufacturing Cortoxin CAR T and our CDH17 CAR T at their facility in Pennsylvania. And I can tell you from having come back from it, it is an incredibly impressive facility, Sage, and we're really looking forward to being able to work with them because it will just help us move our clinical trial programs forward faster.
Sounds great. Best of luck with that joint venture.
Thank you.
And Chimeric also entered into a strategic partnership with Be The March Biotherapies. So it sounds like you've been on an expansionary phase. Can you please tell us how the agreement would advance the company's product development and delivery?
Yeah, absolutely. And I think, you know, the Woozi agreement and the Be The March agreement are really sort of two pieces of the same puzzle. What we've been looking to do, Sage, is put all of the pieces in place that we need to have there so that we can grow our clinical programs out. So we have lots of capacity and capability to be able to have multi-site trials to grow our clinical development programs. And so just as we needed Woozi to be able to manufacture more product, the role of Be The Match actually is something that's a little bit unique to cell therapies. Their role is as a logistics provider. So with CAR T cell therapy, Sage, each individual therapy is made for each individual patient. So we start with taking the blood from a patient somewhere in the world, and then we send that over to the manufacturing facility, Woozi's manufacturing facility in Pennsylvania. They do the genetic engineering there, freeze the cells and send them back to wherever that patient was located. And Be The Match's role really becomes about organizing all of the planes, trains, and automobiles to make sure that the cells get from the patient to the manufacturing facility safely and securely. And then actually the drug product is able to get back to that patient safely and securely. And so, you know, Be The Match is a group that has over 30 years experience doing this. They do it in the United States for all the cell transplants, the stem cell transplants. So great for us to have their expertise and their experience joining us. And really that other piece to the puzzle to make sure that we can expand our programs.
Fantastic. Well, I hope that goes well for you. The cells have to be in perfect condition to be able to work on successfully and to gain the results that you need that are not in some way skewed, I suppose. That's a very important part of the process. You've previously worked on developing and commercializing CAR T-cell therapies. As we finish up the discussion today, Jennifer, how well, do you believe Chimeric is placed to bring the promise of cell therapy to life for more patients with cancer?
Yeah, you know what? Extremely well, Sage. I think that a lot of that comes from insights and experience you learn over time. You mentioned that I've worked on commercializing and developing these types of assets. I've been very fortunate and privileged, I believe, to work on four of the currently approved FDA CAR T-cell therapies. There's only six of them, and I've worked on four of them. And my team has over, together with my team, we have over 50 years experience working in this area. We've worked on over 30 different types of cell therapies. And I think we are incredibly well positioned because of that experience and expertise in this specific area to be able to take the assets that we have that have such incredible scientific promise and bring them through development so that we can get them to the patients. And I really do think that in this space, having that experience and expertise to take the great science forward is critical. So I believe we're positioned in a great way. We have phenomenal science. You can see it. You know, we're seeing clinical trial results. We're seeing our assets featured on very prestigious journals. And when we bring that together with an experienced team, I think we're really well positioned to be able to bring that promise to patients.
Yes. Well, I mean, if the results are proving anything, it's proving that your work is really paying off. And so proud to say that Chimeric is partly an Australian company as well. So thank you so much for sharing your insights today. Was there anything you'd like to share before we close off the discussion, Jennifer?
No, you know, I think we just can look forward to continuing to update everybody on what we're doing. Certainly thank everybody who has been supporting us along the way, and we'll continue to update you on our progress.
That's fantastic. Well, hopefully the next 6 months will be just as busy and profitable as well as successful.
Thank you so much, Sage. It's great to see you.
You too, Jennifer. And if you just joined us, we had a very informative discussion with Jennifer Chow. She's a CEO and Managing Director at Chimeric Therapeutics. Please watch the full interview at Kalkine Media's YouTube channel and keep watching for more of these expert talks and market insights. Till the next episode, stay apprised and invest wise with Kalkine Media.